What's up, guys? This is your boy Passive Crypto checking in once again with another video. This is a video that's dedicated to one of my followers. They asked a question about HyperDragons Go, and they was referring to this video right here. Blockchain Gang's best cryptocurrency game. Make $70 to $150 a week. But before I get started, I really, really would appreciate it if you guys tap that subscription tab and tap that notification bell. That way, you'll be the first ones to see my videos when they drop. So the question was, can you make another video explaining how you make money at this game? If your dragons are not ready for the tournaments, how are you making $70 a week? Thanks. So this video goes out to you. You know who you are. For privacy reasons, I'm not going to say your YouTube name. But, okay, so keep in mind, you have to keep in mind that this video was made in February the 23rd, 2020. So it's April now. So at that time, I was building up this dragon right here. I think you're referring to this dragon right here. This dragon. And it wasn't ready for the tournaments. So I guess they're wondering, well, if it wasn't ready for the big game tournament, how are you making $70 a week? And to answer that question, at that time, I had a dragon. I still do. I have a dragon that's in the Hall of Fame. I don't know if you watched all my videos or not. I explained what the Hall of Fame was in a few of them. So basically, the Hall of Fame is you have to win 10 medals to get inducted into the Hall of Fame. Once you're in the Hall of Fame, you get passive income in this game for life, as long as this game is still, players still playing this game. So at that time, I was the only person in the Hall of Fame. And I get a percentage of this pot every week. So with me not having to share it with someone else, I got a big percentage of this pot. So I was averaging anywhere from 150 ONG upwards of 300, even sometimes, heck, 400 ONG a week, depending on how big the pot was. So that was one of the ways I was still earning income, although I had a dragon that wasn't ready for the big game tournament. And to explain what this means real quick, basically you have to get 10 medals. The only way you can get the 10 medals, you have to place in the top three in the finals match. And the finals match, I'll scroll down to it so you can see. It explains it right here. The finals match, if you place in the top 16, you get ONG and crystals. But if you place in the top three, you get ONG, crystals, and medals. So you have to get three medals from one dragon. And once that one dragon has 10 medals, you get placed in the Hall of Fame. Then you get income from this platform for life. So it took me, I purchased this dragon from somebody actually. I caught it on a discount and I purchased it from someone. And so I started getting income for life from this platform. So in order for anybody else to do it, you either got to purchase a dragon from somebody that's in the Hall of Fame, that dragon that's in the Hall of Fame, or you have to build your way up to 10 medals. This tournament, the final match, is only played once a week. So it could potentially take you 10 weeks to get 10 medals with one dragon. So that was one way. Another way was the Explore Leaderboard. The Explore Leaderboard is another way you earn a lot of ONG. This is paid out once a week as well. As you can see, I already got 108 ONG I can withdraw from this platform right now. I'm not going to do it tonight. You know what? Hey, I'll do it tonight. Why not? Just whipped through 108 ONG from this platform. And it's going to go to my wallet. Should show up any second now. See, bam, it just showed up. So I have 187 now. The 100 and whatever added to what I already had. So 187. So that's another way. If you haven't watched that video, I explain how to earn a lot of ONG on this platform, on this Explore Leaderboard, on this video right here. Best blockchain video games, best crypto game, episode 3. If you watch this video, I explain how the strategy to use, what strategy to use to get the most out of the Explore Leaderboard. As you can see, this person right here, he has top 3 spots. He got all his ONG coming to him. As you can see, it's a lot. So that's 345. He getting like 500 ONG. More than likely, this person has 3 separate wallets, and he just named them all his name. That's the only way I can see him having that many up there at once. That's the only way he could, actually. He got at least 3 separate wallets. They have a mobile app. They have the regular app that you can download on your laptop as well. So they probably got 3 separate apps with 3 separate a whole bunch of dragons, and that's how they leveling up using this strategy that I talked about in Blockchain Video Games episode 3. So check that video out if you haven't seen it. So yeah, so between the Explorer Leaderboard and the Hall of Fame, my dragon being in the Hall of Fame, that was 90% of that $70 to $150 at that time when I made that video. So that's how I was able to make $70 to $150. And that's not including the crystals that I earned, which is these right here. And I was selling those crystals on the crystal market. Excuse me, but my computer moving kind of slow right now. But yeah, I would earn the crystals from different tournaments, and then I would sell them on a crystal market, and I would earn honor and sell an honor as well. The crystal market, I think you make the most money off the crystal market right now, because you need that to level up past level 20. God, my computer moving slow. So as you can see right here, starting at level 21, you need crystals. So you have to level up to be able to place high on the final match. So this is a booming market. You sell the crystals and you get ONG. So I would enter tournaments where crystals were the prize, and then I would sell those crystals on a market. And I will also do the same for the honor market. I will enter different tournaments that have the honor market as the prize. Then once I won the honor, I would sell it on the market. And as you can see, I got 26 dragons. So although that one dragon was a dragon I was focusing on for the final tournament, final match, I still had dragons like this one. Female dragon. If I can find her. This one, my female dragon, this dragon right here would earn me a lot of crystals and a lot of honor, and I would use those earnings and I would sell those crystals and honor and collect more ONG that way as well. So that's how I was able to get 70 to 150 a week. And up until this point also, before I forget, this dragon right here was a big money maker. So I would enter this dragon in the final match, and I would earn a lot of ONG in the final match, because I would place in the top, usually I place in the top 8 or 10 with this dragon, and I would earn a lot of ONG. But it got outdated because the people that were breeding dragons, they were breeding them so fast and powerful that this dragon pretty much didn't do any damage to the newer, stronger dragons. So the other dragon that was in question, that was the one I was training to that point, I decided on not training it further because, for one, they kept breeding dragons that was more stronger and powerful. Well, when I was training my dragon, I fought a few of them and I didn't do anything with them. So I'm not training that dragon anymore. I'm actually training this one for the big game tournament, and I do enter it into the tournaments. As you can see, I placed 9th in the last one, so I won on G. So that adds to my total. And last but not least, you have to remember that video was in February, so at that time ONG was 15 cents. One ONG was worth 15 cents. If you check now, one ONG is only 8 cents. So I'm earning half of that, what I said I would be earning in that February video. So I'm not earning $70 to $150 anymore. I'm earning half of that now. And with me having to split my Hall of Fame earnings with another winner, some of that is cut in half too. So I would say right now I'm probably earning maybe about $30 a week, $40 a week, depending on the prize pools. And if you haven't watched my other videos and you don't know which tournaments you can win the honor and the crystals, one would be the power swap. This one you earn honor. Then another one would be the exclusive zero gen. You earn honor. And as you can see, this is my dragon, and I did earn honor. So I would sell that honor and get ONG. And then the one for the crystals is the female dragon special contest. You earn crystals on that one. And as you can see, I placed 2nd and I got 50 crystals. So this dragon earns me a lot of ONG. And those, if you haven't watched the other videos, those would be some of the tournaments that I recommend that you focus on in the beginning if you're a newbie. And what I would recommend, you would buy dragons that's similar to these dragons' attributes and skill set, because they already proven, they already winning. So you would find dragons on the market that look similar or closely resemble these attributes and skills. And then you would buy those dragons and you would train those dragons and enter them into these type of tournaments that produce income. So I hope that answers your question. I really do appreciate you guys for watching this video, and I'll see you next video. Peace, I'm out.